Okay, folks, I'm gonna show you how to plate this knife. This is just a stainless steel buck knife, I guess you'd call it. We had a customer who tried to plate this side, and as you see, there's some adhesion issues, discoloration, cloudiness, issues. And so he sent it in to us, and I said, well, we'll take a look at it, and we'll plate it for you and film it. What we did first is we polished it. This is critical step. See the luster of the knife? If this is the type of shine and luster that you want when you're done, you have to get it that way before you gold plate. You cannot count on gold plating to change that. Okay, this is what it'll look like if you don't. It's not shiny and it has problems. Now, we've polished this wheel on a buffing wheel. We used white compound on one of the buffing wheels and red rouge on the other. And as you see, we got a nice shiny finish. So we're gonna move forward now and do the plating. First thing I wanna show you real quick is that this is stainless steel, and this is what happens when you put water onto stainless steel. Runs off. Turns, it's like it's waxed. The water just beads up and falls off. Okay? That's a major problem for electroplating. Now, we're going to move right on to the plating and show you how the electrocleaning solves that problem and gets the piece to what we call wet out. So I'm going to pass it over to Terry now. I'm going to continue narrating and he's going to do the plating. Just go ahead. We're set at... we're gonna be set at, let's see, 7.5 volts, maybe 8, anywhere in there will be fine. We've got our common lead plugged in, clipped to the, knife here, and we're doing our work over a Tupperware. Okay, go ahead. He's gonna electroclean. Notice the foaming, bubbling. This will make the piece hydrophilic. Phobic is when it's like has a phobia of it. It pushes it away. It's phobic of the water. That's what we saw before, where the water beads up and falls off. The electroclean makes it hydrophilic. Makes it so it accepts it, you know, and it makes it stay wet once we rinse it off. Really makes it so the solutions are available to get to the surface. This is a key step for stainless steel and steel in general. So you really want to do this beyond when you think you're done, just do a couple more seconds of it, because really underdoing it is more of a problem than overdoing it. In fact, you really can't overdo it. I'm going to show you spraying it off now that it has been electroclean. Look at that. See the puddle even on there? There's no water beads, no water breaks. It's staying wet. It is wet out. Okay. First step, that's important. If it's not, go back over it again. If you noticed any beads or breaks or anything, then go back over it again. Now we're going on to the woods. Same voltage. Quickly go over it with the woods. This isn't something you want to spend a whole lot of time on. This is just a strike. It applies a very thin layer of nickel that you really shouldn't even see. It's more just a preparation step. Some people look for a visible layer of nickel. Not important. If you do, you're overdoing it. See how we've spent maybe 10 seconds on this blade and just made sure we got everywhere quickly. That is a second critical step to steel. Otherwise, gold will not adhere and you'll get that hazy, flaky look that you see on the other side of the blade. So now we turn our voltage down to the gold voltage, which is about anywhere between 4 to 5.5. Depends on how fast you want the gold to go on, how skillful you are. We're gonna go for 4.5. And the gold should immediately start applying within seconds. 1 second. If it's not, either your voltage is low or your preparation is not right. See how it just immediately goes grabs on there. If we were plating the other side, if we could somehow capture the time that the other side was plated, the gold would probably be going on really, really slow. Like, it'd take 10 seconds to even get it to take. And then it would probably only be here and there. And
well, because he didn't activate with woods.
Yeah, and, and between the Electroclean and woods, those two steps make it so the gold goes on correctly. You can't shortcut it. You can't skip steps. You can't change it. That's just how it has to be done. And there you go. That's how you plate a stainless steel knife.
How long do you think you would recommend the person spend doing this?
You could spend, as you can see, you could stop now. Problem is, the gold's really thin. So it really just depends on how thick you want to put it. If this was my knife, I'd plate it for a good 5, maybe even 10 minutes. I mean, you can really just keep caking it on there. If you were doing massive amounts, about every 20 to 30 seconds per square inch is a really thick plate. And this is a hardened 24 karat gold, so it will last quite a long time. Even if you stopped now, that'd be a pretty dang good job.
Okay, we will.
All right, you want to stop now? All right, we'll check it out. This is just such a slick little kit. I mean, you set up, really, as you see, it's 1, 2, 3. As long as you use the right preparation chemicals, which we always give the instructions on, and we'll always provide technical support for, and we always have these videos. I think these videos are very helpful to everybody. See if we can get a good look. All right, look, you can still see the grain structure where the way they made it. We didn't polish that out. So which goes to show, however the surface looks before you gold plate is how it's going to look after. Now show the other side. Here's what it looks like when it goes wrong. And that's simply from improper preparation. No polishing, not correct use of Electroclean and Woods Nickel Strike. And then you get splotchy, flaky. We peeled that gold off with Scotch tape. Alright, well, thanks for watching, guys. This was just the regular universal plater with Electroclean, Woods Nickel Strike, 24K brush gold, and that's all. Thank you.